Hello and welcome. In the next few minutes, we'll walk you through creating a Partner Center developer account, step by step, so you're ready to test and ship your first title. Let's get started. Before we begin, you need to choose which Microsoft identity you'll use to sign into the Partner Center portal. Option 1 is to use a standalone Microsoft account, also called an MSA, which is an account you created by using a domain like @outlook.com or @gmail.com. Option 2 is to use what's called a business Microsoft account. This is a work or school email that is part of your organization's Microsoft 365 subscription. Whichever address you choose, it must belong to you as an individual. Group aliases such as info@, admin@, or marketing@ are not permitted. Next, pick the type of developer account you're creating in Partner Center, individual or company. Here's the quick rule of thumb. Choose individual if you publish as a hobby or side project, sell under your own name, not a registered business, or you are a student or a solo creator. Choose company if you publish on behalf of an LLC, corporation, nonprofit, or government agency, or you work in a team or studio that uses a business domain, or you may need multiple users to manage the account. Individual accounts are perfect for solo dev environments. Company accounts, on the other hand, unlock extra seats and business-level features, but you'll need legal documents and, if prompted, a business registration or tax ID. Please note, once you create an account, you can't switch the type later, so choose carefully. Now that we've made decisions regarding the accounts we'll be using, it's time to collect a few essentials. You must have an individual Microsoft account and a payment method. When selecting a company account on the registration page, there will be a few additional pieces of required information. Specifically, information for a company approver, which is a person who is authorized to manage accounts on behalf of your company. The DUNS number of your registered legal business and an upload of a legal document with your company's name and address. Go to partner.microsoft.com and click on the button that says Become a Partner. When you arrive at the screen, this says, How would you like to partner with Microsoft? Click on the Develop option and then hit Next. Click Login with Work Account. As mentioned earlier, if you are an independent developer, a small-scale creator, or an individual creating digital content, then feel free to use an MSA. On this screen, you will be asked to select which program you are joining. For this example, we will select the Windows and Xbox option, as we will be focusing on game development for both PC and Xbox consoles. For the purpose of this walkthrough, let's select an individual Microsoft account on the registration page. After clicking Next, you'll be taken to a screen to enter your account information. This is the information you want your customers to view in your developer profile. After you enter your address, click the Validate Address button. Review the Windows and Xbox Developer Agreement linked at the bottom, and then select Agree and Continue. The final step of the registration process is to enter your payment information on the Registration Payment Information page. Once entered, click the Submit button, and you're done. When you've made it to the end, your Partner Center account is now in review, and you can expect approval within 3 to 5 business days. If Microsoft needs additional documents, your primary contact will be emailed. To track progress on your application, visit partner.microsoft.com and click Partner Center in the upper right. And that's all there is to it. Congratulations, you've successfully created your Partner Center account. Thanks for watching.